My name is Brian Barczyk. I've been working with exotic animals for over 25 years. I'm no zoologist, just a guy with a passion for animals. And that passion often takes me on animal adventures around the world. This week, I'll travel to Arlington, Texas for the NARBC Reptile Show. There's some amazing animals inside, and I'm gonna go ahead and highlight them. You're watching Snake Bites. So Arlington, Texas is always one of my favorite shows of the year. Not only is it amazing weather in the winter, so I get away from all that cold, but there's certainly some great animals. So let's go inside and take a look. I often talk about the NARBC Reptile Shows, which stands for the North American Reptile Breeders Conference, which are held in Tinley Park, Illinois, Anaheim, California, and where I am this week, Arlington, Texas. These shows are certainly on top of the list for variety and quality of animals. My quest is to bring you some of the coolest animals in the show. So let's go take a look and see what we can find. Well, there's certainly a lot of amazing animals at the show, but you guys know that I'm starting to become somewhat of a lizard maniac. So the first animal I wanted to highlight was this yellow tree monitor, sometimes called the Quincy monitor. Now, these guys are from Indonesia. They get about 4 foot body length, but I tell you what, this is a beautifully tame one because it was raised from a little guy and they are extremely arboreal. But just take a look at that vibrant color. Wow. This is such an awesome animal. In what year was the NARBC's first Texas show ever held? A, 2008, B, 2009, or C, 2010? Go ahead and answer down below in the comments and check back later in the show to see if you have the correct answer. In this week's Reptile Report Spotlight, we'll be highlighting Snakes Forum. Go ahead and check out the URL down below or click on the link in the description. Now this is a real treat for you amphibian nuts. This happens to be a Suriname smooth-skinned toad, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. And its name happens to be Larry, which I think is pretty cool. But just look at how incredible. They look a little bit like the cane toads, but this is as big as they get, and they're very much more beautiful with that kind of peachy red color to them. What's kind of interesting about Larry is that if you pet him right underneath the chin here, he'll actually talk to you. I wish you guys were here to actually hear how cute he is. Now, I've seen the smooth-skinned toads before, but I've never seen a little guy like this, and I'm absolutely blown away by the color. Just look at the contrast right there. This is just such a gorgeous little guy. Take a look. Sticking with the frog or toad genre, this happens to be a Suriname toad. They're one of the largest toads on the planet, and of course, they're really voracious. Look at this guy. They'll eventually get about the size of a dinner plate, and they have quite a big jumping range. Now, unfortunately, the cane toads are a real big invasive problem down in Australia because these guys get around and they eat absolutely everything and just devastate the wild. And unfortunately, they have little poison glands on their back right here. As a matter of fact, if you squeeze this a lot, a little bit of white juice will come out, and that's really bad. So death adders and pythons will actually eat these guys and die from the toxin. So although this guy is really cute, he certainly doesn't belong in Australia. I haven't mentioned this many times, but one of my early loves of reptiles came from this little guy right here. It's an emerald tree boa. Now, these guys come from down in the Amazon, and they're those bright green and white animals you see at the zoos. They're an arboreal snake, and they're truly amazing. What's really interesting about this guy is that when they're born as babies, they're red and white, and then they slowly turn green. This guy's right in the middle. It's starting to get its green in, but it still has that really beautiful red. You can certainly see the white coming through too. Now, the whole purpose for this is that when they're born, they'll stay down in the canopy in the flowering trees that are typically red, so it's good for camouflage. And again, they're an ambush hunter, so they're just gonna hang out in a tree, and when a prey comes around, wham, they're gonna hit it. And of course, when they get older, they start to turn green. They move up in the canopy to catch birds. These guys have some huge teeth, and this is absolutely a beauty. Although this certainly isn't a reptile, it's such a cute animal. His name is Pumpkin, and it's a the white-bellied caique. These guys are from South America, mainly Brazil. What makes pumpkin so special is, unfortunately, it got its beak bit off by another bird, but it absolutely does completely fine without it. It eats and it's gonna have a great life. I tell you what, although it's a little weird without that beak, it certainly is adorable. I'm at the West Texas Herpetological Society's table, and I have a beautiful snake here. This happens to be a Christmas Mountains Blair's Phase Gray Banded Kingsnake. Now, what's really interesting about a lot of the Texas herpers is it's really famous for hunting alterna, which are gray banded kingsnakes, and the locality-specific animals are very important. And this is a relatively typical Christmas Mountains Blair's Phase here. It's got those dark gray bands with that really bright orange color. This is a beautiful snake. And again, I absolutely love the fact that these guys get together once a year, head out west, and go hunt these animals in the wild. I tell you what, I've got to get out there one of these years. It's really cool when you run across unusual pythons at shows. This happens to be a Maklots python. They're from Indonesia, and this is a pretty big girl here, so she's not going to get much larger than that. And they're really kind of known for being somewhat aggressive, but as you can see, this guy is a puppy dog tame animal and happens to be a mascot that's been kind of walking around the show. So as soon as I saw it, I said, I've got to grab it and show it off to you guys. Check this out. This has to be one of the coolest, or should I say, two coolest animals in the show. That's right, this happens to be a Siamese twin. It's a red-eared slider, and I tell you, it's just absolutely crazy to see. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4 legs and 2 heads, but only 1 body and 2 little legs in the back. Now that is one unique animal. This is a veiled chameleon from the Yemen area in Africa, and this happens to be a male. Now the males are much more beautiful. They have this nice big crest on them. And the thing that's unique to all chameleons, the fact that they have independent eyes. So literally, one eye can be looking this way, the other eye can be looking a completely different way, which makes them kind of interesting. And also they have that crazy feed thing going on with their tongue. They'll key in on a cricket, they'll shoot their tongue out, and that little stickiness on the end will grab the cricket and pull it back into their mouth. I tell you what, these are certainly a cool animal, but now most people think chameleons can change color, but the truth is all they can do is get lighter and darker depending on the temperature and their mood. Tell you what, I'm loving this guy, and he's definitely a little bit feisty. Now this is a real treat for me. One of the first snakes that I ever bred happened to be a Solomon Island boa, which are Candoia carinata. This happens to be a close relative. It's a viper boa, which is Candoia asper, but they get really fat and are much shorter. They kind of remind me of the blood python of the boa world because they're just little fat sausages with that really crazy shovel head. I tell you, you don't see too many of these around, so whenever I get the opportunity to play with one, I'm certainly all about doing it. People ask me all the time when I come to these reptile shows, am I gonna buy anything and take it home? But I tell you what, this is certainly the animal that needs to come home with me. You hardly ever see these guys. These are 100 flower rat snakes, or Orthriopus melandorfi. They come from south central China up to the north of Vietnam, and they're really a unique colubrid. First off, they can get up to 9 feet long and this big around, and the reproductive part is really unique as well. They'll have up to 9 eggs, but unlike most shell, these guys actually have a hard shell, and when the babies hatch, they actually have to break their way out of the side of the egg because their egg tooth can't cut the egg. Now this animal seems to be a little more special. It's hypomelanistic. It's a recessive mutation that basically just means that it's lacking a lot of the black, but not all of it, so it's not albino. It just makes it look that much more beautiful. Now there's only about 10 of these guys in the entire world. I tell you what, this definitely takes the cake for the coolest animal in the show. I shot the snake when it was a baby and I was so impressed with it, but now that it's a year old and a good 5 or 6 foot long, I'm absolutely blown away. This is a super motley fire reticulated python. Now the motley and fire are both codominant mutations, so a super motley is essentially a patternless reticulated python, and then the fire just really brightens it up and makes this kind of blue-gray python that is just crazy looking. Can you just imagine when this snake is 15 or 16 foot long, how incredible it's gonna look? I tell you what, I love reticulated pythons, and this is definitely one of my favorite morphs. This is a black water monitor. Now, you guys have seen my night niles that are from Africa. They stay a little bit smaller and are much more aggressive. The water monitors get quite large and are pretty docile as adults. Although this guy is a baby, he gave me a little bit of a nip earlier that hurt pretty good. Now, some people think that there's some outcroppings of islands that actually have all populations of the black monitors, but I'm not really sure if that's the case. Basically, it's a recessive mutation that is melanistic, so there certainly could be some populations that have thrived with the melanistic or black look and have actually created a population of them. Either way, that jet black animal with those really dark eyes, that's a beautiful, beautiful lizard. There's a lot of incredible ball pythons in the show, but this one certainly caught my eye. Believe it or not, this used to just be a normal yellow killer bee, but when it finally got gravid and went through a prelay shed, overnight it went from a yellow and black animal to this steel gray and white animal. Essentially, everywhere where there was yellow turned white, and then this whole part here turned this bluish gray. Now, it probably is something that has to do with the hormonal change when an animal becomes gravid, but nevertheless, this is absolutely stunning. Now, we're not sure if it's going to be something that's going to be able to be hereditary and passed on or not, but I sure hope so, because this is an animal I would love to own. This is a really cool snake that, again, you rarely see around. This is a South American colubrid that's called a tiger rat snake. It's a Spilodes pilatus, and they're really kind of interesting in the fact that they stay really skinny and kind of triangular. They never really beef out, and they always look like they're a little bit underweight, but that's just the way that they are. They're a very arboreal snake, but what's really impressive about them is that jet black and yellow animal. And sometimes these guys can be a little bit cantankerous, but this guy is behaving pretty well, and they get really large. I've seen Spilodes that have been 9 foot long, and they're typically bird and lizard eaters mainly, but in captivity, sometimes you can get them over to rodents, but again, it's just cool to see an animal that you hardly ever see at shows. Well, I tell you what an amazing day walking around playing with all these animals. And although I took a couple of bites here and there and leaked a little bit, it certainly was worth it. I tell you, this Texas show is certainly one of my favorite shows. Just all the animals and so many incredible people. What an awesome time. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did filming it for you. In what year was the NARBC's first Texas Reptile Show ever held? If you said A, 2008, you're 100% correct. Good job. So there it is. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. There certainly were some amazing animals. And of course, I'm going home with some goodies myself. And as always, I was Facebooking and tweeting my way through it. So make sure to follow me over at Snake Bites TV. Until next week, you've been watching Snake Bites.